Hi Ryan, welcome back to another video of mine, and today we're gonna do another unboxing video. And what we have here is of course the Dragon Momoko Master Grade Avalanche XCR Dash. As you guys know, this kit released quite some time ago, but because I did not have the time, so yeah, I got delayed for this unboxing. But nonetheless, now we still take a look. So of course at the front here we have this amazing box art as always by Dragon Momoko. And then here you guys can see Trans-Arm System Avalanche XCR Dash. I'm not sure why they say it's Trans-Arm System, because if it's Trans-Arm System, I guess it's just the name, because if once you mention Trans-Arm, it would basically means that this whole mobile suit will be in the Trans-Arm mode, which will be the sort of like the pink color sort of that. So yeah, I'm not sure why they want to name it the Trans-Arm System over here. So yeah, you guys can see the box is really huge, can't really fit into this whole frame, so of course I will have to bring it up to zoom in for you guys to see time and time again. So yeah, I'm not sure if there's anything nice for you guys to see, because if there's anything nice, I would have covered it in the news there. So yeah, I mean basically just like that. And of course here again, based on the arm like I mentioned, this is in silver color, can't focus, so yeah, I'll just leave it there. And then now we'll take a look at the side here. Of course, as always, at the side here you have the computer product. So from here, this is the back of it, the back view or rear view they would say. And then here you guys can see the front view. Of course, based on this, it shows that it can stand, but I'm not really sure whether it will be a back heavy, so that's the thing we see. Or maybe you guys can see here, this part will act like a support. So yeah, until we fix it, we still don't know how it will go. And then here guys can see it says detail display, almost same presentation as the Bandai non-grade 1-100 for the Avalanche XCR as well. So yeah, here are some of the information. So if you guys want to read, you guys can pause, I'm moving on now. So of course next here, you guys can see here this is the flying mode. And then here is the weapon. Then it says here it comes with two modes. One of course is with the silver color, and then here is sort of like in the heat mode. So yeah, and then here you guys can combine. This is sort of like a boomerang, I would say. So go on to the next part here. Of course here is the same thing as well. Here is without all its bulkiness, so basically this is just the weapons and the armor. And then here again, same thing, the detail display. And then here, there are a total of 3 GN sword, and then 3 short one, and this is the GN sword as well. So there are 3, 6, 7, and then here you have it. So yeah, basically just like that, the box art, very simple. And then here you guys can see this is the top, it will be the same as the bottom here. And then here is of course the other side of it. Here you guys, this box art, this part here, you guys can see that the XCR already drawn out is long GN sword and the short GN sword. So yeah, and then it's without the bulky weapon at the back here. So yep, basically that's really it. The next part of course we'll take a look at the parts that it comes with. And of course because there are too many parts of it, I might just speed up. If there's like nothing really like how to say detailed part to show you guys, I'll just move on. But as well, I will just bring it up to show you guys like what this part is. So yeah, without further ado, let's head on to the reviewing of the parts. So I have this huge box ready to put back all the parts inside. I've just removed it and I think that I saw some pretty interesting stuff of it. So yeah, as always, I want to start with stickers, because most of the time I always forget to show you guys what are the stickers that it comes with. So first thing here is this sort of like a transparent piece here. If I'm not mistaken, it will be used at the shoulder armor there, like every XCR. So it's kind of cool to see that this is like transparent, you guys can see, like this piece here. I'm not sure how flexible it is, hopefully that it will really bend easily and not break that easily, or else it will be very disappointed. As you guys know, the shoulder armor you need to move around, so it will be easily to break. Then right here, you have a couple of stickers here. You have one, this piece over here. Let me just focus. You have like a piece here, just plain silver. And then you have this, of course, all the cover up parts to cover up the other parts that you need touch up. And then here are the batteries. Of course, it says there's two. This one should be the chest. This one should be the head. So yeah, and by the way, this will be my first time putting LED into the kit. So yeah, it will be fun to see. So next, we'll cover up all the short parts first, then all the short parts, then we move on to all the bigger parts of for this kit. So the first part here we have is the yellow piece here. This, I guess, will be used on the legs, the back of the leg, because you have this hook here. So there's one for here. Then next here, you have three pieces of this piece. This, I'm not sure what armor part that you will be using this, but this is a G part of it. So you have total of three. So yeah, let me just put again at the side here. Then the next part here, you guys have the transparent part. So of course here you guys can see it's the GN00001. So it's good to see. You have the detail over here. And then this part should be the LED part. And then I don't think there's anything else to show you guys. But you guys, I just want to show you guys again here. The GN001, the detail looks quite good. That is imprinted onto it. So yeah, that's good to see. Next, we take a look at this red part here over here. Again, this should be the side armor here. And then this one should be the legs, the base of the leg. Again, it kind of looks very small. You guys can see, it's just so short and small. I wonder how it will fit up to it. So yeah, there's another part gone. And next here, you have these two long grey part over here. This is the end part. Again, nothing much to show you guys, so we just move on. Then you have this huge piece. This is the, if I'm not mistaken, this should be the back, this should be part of the legs. Don't know which part, but it should be part of the legs. This is a C part over here, we'll put here. And next we have this three white pieces part here, the K part. This guy can see is the gen sword here, white color, the short and long gen sword. And then here is the handle. Maybe you guys want to take a look at the detail of the handle. So yeah, the handle basically you guys can see is just like that, nothing much. So again, just let me put it down over here. Then next here we have the polycaps. Surprisingly, this polycap, it's only so little. I was expecting much more. Maybe later we'll be able to see more of the polycaps. And then next here we have the white, another white piece here. This should be the skirt armor part. Then this part should be the shoulder armor, what part of the armory. So yeah, again, nothing much to see. And then here, yellow piece, this should be the armory, to be used at the armory as well. This one is very, this design is very common in the 00, the series. As in, let's shoot out the particles, I forgot what is it called. I keep on remembering that it's prophecy particles, which is build fighters use it. But I forgot what is it called in the 001. But yeah, nonetheless, here is another grey piece. Again, nothing much. I'm not sure what this piece will be used for. And here, another piece here. Again, don't know what, just small part here. So maybe you guys want to see some detail. Again, these small parts doesn't really tell you much. So yeah, it's quite difficult. And then as always, all the Dragon Momoko, the hands now, they come with this pose. Fixed pose hands, and then of course you have again these movable hands. So yeah, you guys can choose which one to use. As always, now that I've bought quite a number of Dragon Momoko kits, I've quite a number of hands already. And then here again, another handler. This the armor here. So yeah, let me just put here. And then here are more. I think you guys would know. This one is usually the hand, the back of the hand here. And then this one, within, maybe you guys want to have a look. So yeah, short small detail over here. And then yeah, the rest just like that. And then next here you guys have the GN sword. So yeah, that's it. This two that you give two. So most probably you just fix up like that. And just put it down here. And then next you have two of this grey piece. So yeah, where it's sort of relatively fast because like I see nothing much to show you guys. And then here you guys can see this one would be fit into the one of the main, this should be the main body here. LED should be shine upon here. Then this one should be the back. And then anything else? Nothing much to show you guys. Maybe the back of the detail. So yeah, basically that's it. And one last part over here, which is this blue color part. Again, the blue looks quite nice. This K2 part. So yeah, I would say the small parts here are done. Now we'll take a look at the bigger parts one. So here is our first plastic part. This one I did not remove because you have this, the huge, to be used as the stand. So yeah, did not want to remove it first. And then here, really nothing much to show you guys. Maybe here, you guys can see the skirt armor. Yeah, this piece here. And then the rest, you guys can see the detail. So yeah, I guess just put it here. And then next, you have two parts of this. Let me just refocus again. This, I don't know what we will be using it for, but yeah, should be the inner frame, if I'm not mistaken. And then next here, you have this white piece. Again, should be the, okay, so guys, you can see basically here, you can see the circle over here, it means basically somewhere around the arm or the legs. And then here another white piece, white parts. I don't know what would be again, so yeah, maybe you guys just have to guess. I would say this part over here will be used at the armory, the shoulder part there. So yeah, another part done. And then here another piece here. This one was previously found in this pile over here, and I'll put it there, so I'll just put it here. And then next here, you guys can see this part again should be the mobile suit, the body here. Again, nothing much to show you guys. Maybe here you guys want to see the detail. This should be the hand. These two should be the hand. Either that, then it will be the legs. And then here you guys can see another one. This should be the weaponry. This looks like the boomerang handle. So yeah, there's no detail, just I think this should be part and parcel of it. So just put it here. And then here again, there's not much detail. But here you guys can see this part here is very detailed. There's actually like segregation parts of it. So that's good to see. So yeah. Next one here. Again, this is the same part as the previous one, so don't need to show you guys. And then here, this piece. This one should be the shield for it, the GN sword. So yeah, again, done here. And then next here is another part. This is the another part that I showed you guys previously, when I'm reviewing the big part over there. So this part is basically seen. And then now here, we have a blue piece here. This is of course to be used as the GN sword. So yeah, there are still a couple of parts to show you guys, then we'll move on to the manual. So of course, this comes with the base, the Avalanche Axia Celestial Being mobile suit. Here are some detail. So if you guys want to read, you guys can pause now. So yep, I'm moving on. This up top here, and then the parts that I've been awaiting for confirmation is none other than this, the weapons. So you guys can see it's basically this chrome silver, so it's very nice and good to see. So all my doubts now, like, okay, it's gone. I can confirm that everything here is silver. Here you guys can see the long Jian sword and the short Jian sword. So side here. And here's the main one. The one comes with the normal Axia, the Jian sword over here. So yeah, again, it looks very good. You do not have like sort of like the bubble, you know, like some uneven tone. So yeah, everything it looks very refined, very good finish. So you get a total of 3 of this Jian sword here. And then this part here, I did not want to remove the plastic, but then yeah, this basically here is all the beam saber, the effect. And then here, this is the other one. When I show you guys the box art, you can see the switch the color. This is like the transparent green. So yeah, so basically all the parts there is just like that. So now we'll move on to the manuals. So the manual is just basically like this, trying to focus. So yeah, basically just at the front here. You guys can see the posing here, the detail of it. Here you guys can see the beam effect here, quite long. And then here are the weapons that's mounted at the back. See here, you have 3 of each of the short blade and the long blade. You guys can see he's holding the weapon. And then over here, you guys can see he's about to draw his Jian sword. Part of his Jian sword, I would say. So yeah, here's the part that I would want to count, which is the part counts of it. Right, so there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, 24, 25, 26, 27, 28, 29, 30, 31, 32, 33, 34, 35, 36, 37, 38, 39, 40, 41, 42, 43, 44, 45, 46, 47, 48, 49. So there are a total of 49 parts, including the LED that I counted. So if you remove LED, it would be 47. And then so yeah, as I said here, the polycaps, it is just this small part here. So I really don't know the manual of the kit how it goes, but yeah, nonetheless, we now take a look at the assembling here, all the tools. Let's try to focus better colors. So yeah, here you guys can see, here is the LED, of course, that teach you how to do everything. I try to see whether there's LED on the head. Okay, apparently there's no LED towards the head. The only LED that you're gonna get is the body. So yeah, it's kind of sad. And then here you guys have the movable hand, and then here we have the arms and stuff. Here's the armor altogether. I hope that this part will stick towards the body. Hopefully there won't be any loose parts, or else you have to use glue, which I do not like to use it. Then here you guys can see the leg unit. Again, this is very bulky kit. So yeah, you guys can see just the assembling here. If I, the person who actually draw this plan, I really have to praise him for doing all that. You guys can see here, part at the back of the leg. And here is how bulky it is. It's almost like the gun tank, you know, like based on that reference. So yeah, you guys can customize using gun tank to make into a mobile suit as well. And then yeah, here's just the weapons. And then yeah, basically that's it really. And here are the sticker guides. And then here there are more of the art of it. Just here again, this I think is the same as the previous I showed you guys. So yeah, basically that's really it. Yeah, nothing really much to show. Then here you guys can see the bottom of the legs here, you can extend into like a hand, can grab some stuff. That's sort of like the ball mobile suit, if you guys know that one. It's the World Car one, World Car the ball. Then yeah, here like I say, can change from this the silver chrome to this sort of like the transparent light green. So yeah, basically just here the end. Yeah, here 2017. So yeah, that's it for today's unboxing. I hope you guys have enjoyed this video. If you guys have enjoyed, please do not forget to drop a like down below and subscribe to me, as there will be more videos coming out very soon. Similar to this type, be it figure review or Gunpla review or some other Japanese related stuff that I might just review it. So yeah, anyway, if during this video I sound kind of weird, it's because I have sort of like a throat infection. Like I would talk a little bit, I would feel the urge to cough, and then I have to like hold it down a bit. So yeah, nonetheless, I hope my future videos will not have this problem, of course. So yeah, I hope you guys have a good day, and yeah, see you guys very soon.